In this video, we'll talk to the farmers about the economics of strip tillage system and explore the cost of equipment, labor, and fertilizer, and how those factor into the overall cost of production. So Christine and Warren, we want to talk about the economics, the cost of production of your strip till system. What level of the farm operation do you calculate your cost of production at?
For the most part, enterprise level. We are getting more and more defined zones in fields and are trying to do some cost of production per zone. But for the most part, it's at the field. Or enterprise scale.
So again, considering the cost of production and the economics associated with your production system, how important was the economics in the decision to move to strip till?
Extremely important. We were looking at a very aging equipment for us. Our cultivators were very old. The fertilizer application equipment was getting tired. And so we were gonna have to spend some money, and really liked the idea of strip till. Speaking with mentors, producers throughout North America, they're telling stories of a reduced cost of production, but again, you have to see it to believe it on your own operation. And we've definitely seen improvements, particularly fuel, labor, time, and getting things done in a timely fashion.
How did your farm size impact your decision to switch over to strip till?
Yeah, so I think farm size and maybe where you're at in your farming career maybe have a little bit of an impact on that decision making matrix as well. For us, we were of sufficient size that is, for us the 12 row system kind of carried itself. So we could make that investment. Especially if you're going to have some sort of dry fertilizer application system with it, that really starts adding costs. Some sort of Montag or Valmar or whatever it is, granular fertilizer applicator can really add to it as well. We were fortunate enough; we got into it. We personally had enough size; we could probably make it work. We did have a couple of friends though that had asked about. The system, and we're very interested if we had a rig, would you do work for us? And so I have probably a half a dozen or so people that are don't have the scale to justify their own system, that we do their work, and it makes two people happy. We're able to spread our capital costs across a few more acres. And for a lot of them, several of my customers are actually late in their farming career, and are single proprietor, like lone wolves as far as their spring system, and have essentially said, you know, strips have made me stay going this long because no longer do I have to go out and try to beat dirt down with a cultivator, all night so I can plant during the next day and rinse and repeat. I come in, I make their strips in the fall for them, and essentially it's a very simple system now. They come out, they have one job in the spring just like I do, and that is to get the corn planter out of the shed and plant corn.
So can you talk about the cost and the time associated with preventative maintenance in the strip till system compared to how you used to crop?
Now that we've gotten our strip till bar, we bought it used, so now that it is up to where we like to keep our maintenance, we could have it looked over in and out of the shop in a day or, I'll say 2 to 3 days, assuming there's no major welding faults in it. We still do look over all the other equipment every year, but because it's being used less, there is less damage on it, less wear points. You don't need to replace as much as often. So it is overall less.
So guys, have you been able to make strip till a win, both from the standpoint of cost of production and from the standpoint of your goals for soil health?
Oh, definitely. As we've touched on, we're less passes over the field, less tractors. We've seen so many more worms.
Water infiltration is uh, definitely increased. It's been great.